Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nidger. Here is part two of the Ideal Church of God. Thus, the close circle laborers of Jesus were to teach the rectified moral laws of Moses in honor of John the Baptist and to preach the gospel in honor of Jesus. Further, the 12 had nothing to do with the 12 tribes of Israel and the 12 secular thrones, which these Matthew 19:28, which these greedy bishops thought, you know, that they were ruling over the world with their authority, so they wanted these only secular kingdoms. Then Jesus has nothing to do with secular kingdoms. As the Moses priests could not be a woman, but men only, so the 12 were all men, and it was the laborers who were baptizing men in water on behalf of John, but not of Jesus, as he was not a teacher, but a preacher. So laborers, they never baptized a woman, as John never baptized a woman. The 12 laborers hired by Jesus were paid their wages, the Holy Spirit, on Pentecost, Matthew 20:8. So when even was come, the Lord of the vineyard is the word, Lord is God, saith unto his steward, Christ Jesus, call the laborers and give them their hire, beginning from the last unto the first. This I have explained already, you know, it's the spiritual things are opposite to the physical things. The last one is paid first and the first one is paid last. The laborers of Jesus had forsaken worldly treasures for the sake of their wage, the Holy Spirit, Matthew 19:27. Then answered Peter and said unto him, Behold, we have forsaken all and followed thee, what shall we have therefore? Thus the laborers of Jesus, who first founded the Church of God, headed by Christ Jesus, sold all their belongings to share a perfect communal life, but the limitations of human flesh led them to some grumbling over such matters as to the distribution of food. You remember there is in America some communities which are based upon this ideal Church of God, in which they share everything and they are living in a peace and harmony. But these Jewish people, they were a bit clever, so they always, you know, had some problems. This problem was resolved by the apostles in Acts 6:1-4. Wherefore, brethren, look ye out among you 7 men, and not a single woman, because these 7 were in the name of John the Baptist, of honest report, full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom, whom we may appoint over this business. Now, this 7 were to look after the moral affairs of the church, and they were all men, not a single woman. But we will give ourselves continue to prayer and to the ministry of his word. So among themselves, the 7 deacons elected a bishop or a supervisor, and the deacons were encouraged to teach the moral laws of Moses to people, but they were not permitted to preach his word, as the preachers could not be the resident members of the congregation, but the roving saints who went from church to church ironing out the spiritual problems of the congregations. And their praises rested not with people but with God, who ordained them into his service. The preachers possessed the double-edged sword of his word, one edge clearing their own misconceptions and the other edge clearing those of the congregations. The other reason that is based upon the general principle, what applies to flesh, the opposite applies to spirit, is that the moral teachers, Matthew 13:52, are hereditary and resident of male sex only, because male have the identity, and the moral teachers are to teach little children or young people moral education, and they are to be responsible. The women on marriage, they change their surname, and their responsibility is not good. In the Middle East, we have only Kohen and Levi tribe, but in India, we have quite a few tribes who are assigned this duty of teaching moral laws. The preachers of gospel are to be non-hereditary and non-resident persons of either sex. That is, a woman cannot teach the moral laws, but she can preach his word, the gospel. Further, the teachers of moral laws have to be authoritarian in the manner of John the Baptist, who publicly denounced the marriage of Philip's wife with Herod, Matthew 14:3, whereas the preachers of Jesus, or the saints of God, have to be humble and loving servants. The two qualities are not easy to mix, and the exception was Peter, who possessed the keys to the kingdom of heaven as well. Above all, if a preacher of gospel becomes a resident member of the congregation, he may soon seek the praises of people rather than those of God, as it is prevalent today in the churches, where the hired dog-collar clerics of Mammon happily bless the soldiers of Mammon who died fighting for the kings and countries, and further pronounce them as to have glorified God, our merciful and loving Father. Thus, what will Jesus think of St. Paul's Cathedral in London that is full of the heroes of Mammon, Matthew 7:21? So, in churches of God, the people should be free of the Mammon attraction, or if they are working, as we are at present, the people who go to such a church, they should be morally sound, and it is the duty of the bishop of each church to see that no person in their church has of evil spirit, or somebody who cheat the other people. If anybody reports that such a person has done wrong thing to somebody, the bishop should take action and give him appropriate punishment. But these are being the organization of Mammon. They are blind guides of the blind. They don't want to lose their blind sheep in case the number dwindles and their income also dwindles, and they are put off their business, or they are left dry and hungry. So these are people in the churches, and as you can see how the Pope is Antichrist, standing between man and God. So these people are Antichrist, who lure the people into churches, and the only way to lure the people to churches is to feed them sugar-coated tablets of falsehood. Falsehoods are sweet, sweeter than honey, but they kill people in thousands. So these sectarian riots, which you find them, they are the outcome of these hireling bishops and priests in the churches. If they were not hireling and they voted to God, then they would seek the praises of God, not of men, and such thing won't happen. So that's why many people who have become atheists, because these bishops and other people, are nothing good is coming out of them. They all create problems. And that's why people say, there's nothing good coming out of the religion. It's not the religion that's bad, it's the people who are bad. And we have to sort it up. And here we give the part 3 of the Ideal Church of God. Thank you.